فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
The third one is Hakim Abu Abdullah. He said that the shadh is the hadith الَّذِي يَنْفَرِدُ بِهِ الثِّقَةِ. Shadh is that which a person who is a thiqah, he singles in. From the other thiqat. وَلَيْسَ لَهُ أَصْلٌ. And it has no original what? بِمُتَابَعَ. It has no other mutaba'a. Write the word mutaba'a because we're going to come to it in this lesson today. And it has no other mutaba'a for that person. لِذَلِكَ الثِّقَةِ. For that particular thiqah. He has no mutaba'a. The strongest, inshallah, is the ta'rif as given by Imam Ibn Hajar, rahimahullah. It is that which ma rawahu al-maqbool mukhalifan liman huwa awla minhu. It is that which a person who is a maqbool, accepted person, whose narration is accepted, goes against liman huwa awla minhu. He goes against somebody who is more rightful than him. Somebody who is more rightful than him. And Imam al-Iraqi, rahimahullah, he says in his Alfiyah, وَذُ الشُّذُودِ مَا يُخَالِفْ ثِقَهُ فِيهِ الْمَلَافَ الشَّافِعِيُّ حَقَّقَهُ وَالْحَاكِمُ الْخِلَافُ فِيهِ مَشْتَرَطْ وَلِلْخَلِيلِيُّ الْمُفْرَدُ الرَّاوِي فَقَطْ وَرَدَّ مَا قَالَا بِفَرْضِ الثِّقَةِ كَالنَّهِي عَنْ بَيْعِ الْوَلَاءِ وَالْهِبَةِ وَقَوْلُ مُسْلِمَ رَوَى الزُّهْرِيُّ 90 فَرْدًا كُلُّهَا قَوِيُّ. Okay. An example for this one is the same one that we mentioned. إِذَا صَلَّى أَحَدُكُمْ رَقْعَتَيِّ الْفَجْرِ فَلْيَضَّجْعَ عَلَى يَمِينِ. Because if you look at it from one angle, it's the person opposed, and the one that's been opposed, we mentioned, is mahfuz and shad. What's the ruling regarding the hadith which is shad? It goes in the what types? It's rejected. And it's a hadith which is weak. It's rejected. The hadith which is shad? Is rejected. It's not accepted. Nah. I said that if there's a ziyadat al-thiqah, no, I said if there's a hasan and he opposes a sahih,
yeah.
The hasan is called what?
It's called shad.
The hasan is called shad. What about that?
Sahih is called mahfuz.
The hasan right now becomes what? Mardood, is rejected.
Okay.
Naam, and he becomes da'if. And he becomes what?
Yeah.
It becomes da'if now. Then Hafiz ibn Hajar rahimahullah, he goes into another one, another type. وَمَعْ ضَعْفِ الرَّاجِحُ الْمَعْرُوفُ وَمُقَابِلُهُ الْمُنْكَرُ. Now we've taken, if they're both thiqah, and opposition came. What is an opposition comes, which one do you take?
The more thiqah, right?
What about if a weak person goes against a thiqah? So this is what we're going to now take him. وَمَعَ الضَّعْفِ. If there's a weakness, وَقَعَتِ الْمُخَالَفَةُ الرَّاوِيُّ الثِّقَةُ مَعَ ضَعْفِ الرَّاوِيِّ الْمُخَالِفِ فَالرَّاجِحُ يُسَمَّى الْمَعْرُوفُ وَمُقَابِلُ مَرْجُوحُ يُقَالُ لَهُ الْمُنْكَرُ. The one who is weak, who opposed what? He's weak. He's ضعيف. And he opposed what? A thiqah. The weak one is called what? A munkar. Huh? The weak one is called a munkar. And the thicker one is, the strong one is called what? Mahfuz. It's called ma'ruf. So now we're going to take the munkar. As we're going to take later, inshallah, and we did mention in last lessons, that the hadith, the ways that the hadith becomes weak is that either the chain of narration is disconnected, or the adala of the rawi. The third, we said, it's ima at-ta'nu.
The
criticism that happens to the narrator, which is أطعن في الراوي, the narrator is being criticized, or something to do with the chain of narration. Those two, right? Good. Now, If the narrator, the sabab of the narrator's criticism is because of fuhshul ghalat, he does crazy mistakes, ridiculous mistakes, or kathratul ghafla, or he's consistently heedless, which we're going to take very well, inshallah, or will fisq, or it's something to do with him being a fasiq, yeah? That hadith is called munkar. That hadith is called munkar. So it's either fuhshul ghalat, he does ridiculous mistakes, the mistakes are very bad, or kathratul ghafla, or he's seriously heedless, or al-fisq, he's a fasiq. Fasiq is a person doing major sins. Drinking khamar, lying. Sorry, not lying, but it means drinking khamar, zina. Kadhib has another one. So it's fisq. That hadith, that person's hadith, that hadith is called munkar. It's going to be munkar. We're going to see it inshallah in details. Suyuti rahimahullah says, Al-munkaru alladhi rawa ghayru thiqah. Mukhalifun fi nukhbatin qad haqqaqa. Munkar is the hadith narrated by a thiqah. Other than a thiqah, sorry. It's the hadith that's narrated by other than a thiqah, who opposes a scholars who are thiqah, as I mentioned. Iraqi rahimahullah, he says, وَالْمُنْكَرُ الْفَرْدُ كَذَا الْبَرْدِيجِ أَطْلَقَ وَالصَّوَابُ فِي التَّخْرِيجِ إِجْرَاءَ تَفْصِيلٍ لَدَ الشُّذُوذِ مَرْ فَهُوَ بِمَعْنَى كَذَا الشَّيْخُ ذَكَرْ نَحُوْ كُلُ الْبَلَخَ بَلَحَ بِالتَّمْرِ الْخَبَرْ وَمَالِكٌ سَمَى بْنُ عُثْمَانَ عُمَرْ. An example of that is going to be this hadith. A hadith which is munkar. Is the hadith narrated by Ibn Abi Hatim, narrated a hadith min tariq Hubayb ibn Habib, and he's the brother of Hamza ibn Habib, Az-Ziyat an al-Muqri, who narrated from Ishaq ibn Ya'zar ibn Huraith, an Ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, man aqama as-salah, anyone who establishes the prayer, wa ata al-zakat, and comes with the zakat, wa hajj al-bayt, and he does hajj to the house of Allah, وصام رمضان, and he fasts the month of Ramadan, وقر الضيف, and he gives the rights of the guests, دخل الجنة, he will enter Jannah. Tabarani narrated and Ibn Adi and other than them. Abu Hatim said this hadith is munkar, because لأن غير من الثقات, because other scholars of hadith هو ثقات رواه عن أبي إسحاق, they narrated it from this guy أبي إسحاق, they narrated it from him in what way? موقوفا, not marfu', meaning as the speech of Ibn Abbas. They narrated it as Ibn Abbas' speech. Lakin, this man, Hubayb ibn Habib, he narrated it marfu'. Are you with me? So the narration of his is what? His narration is, the narration of Hubayb ibn Habib is munkar. And then other narration, other than them is what? Is called ma'ruf. Naam. Some of the scholars like Ibn Salah, they don't distinguish between the munkar and the shadh. For them it's the same. Some of the ulama of hadith, like Ibn Salah, he didn't distinguish between munkar and what? Shadh. Munkar and shadh. And that's why Iraqi's bait that I read, that's the way he's talking about it. Naam. But there is a difference between the two, as we mentioned. We took it in Bayquniya, right? وَمُنْكَرُ الْفَرْدُ بِهِ رَاوٍ غَدَى تَعْدِيلُهُ لَا يَحْمِلُ تَفَرُّدَى. When we took Bayquniya. So I mentioned two ta'rifs, if you guys remember what I said. We'll repeat it inshallah before we move on. The first one is what? That some of the scholars, they said that the hadith, الحديث الذي في إسناده, in it, the chain of narration is a rawi, a narrator. فُحْشُ الْغَلَط. أو كثرت غفلته, excessive heedlessness, أو ظهر الفحش, أو ظهر فسقه, sorry, or he's fasiq. That's the first definition according to some of the ulama of hadith. Okay, the second one is ما رواه الضعيف, it is the narration that it comes from a weak individual, مخالفا لما رواه الثقات, and he goes against the narration of people who are more stronger than him, sorry, who are reliable narrators. He's a weak narrator. He opposes those who are reliable narrators. Ibn Hajar mentions both of them in his Nukhbat al-Fikr and in Nuzhat al-Nazar. So what's the difference between, what is the difference between a munkar and a shad? The munkar of the shad is ma rawahu al-maqbool. Shad is the narration of a person who is maqbool, who is accepted. He narrates, he opposes what? Liman hu awla minhu. He opposes somebody who is greater than him. But he's a reliable person, his hadith can be taken. Whereas the munkar is what? Ma rawahu al-da'ifu. It is the narration of a weak person. Mukhalifa lima rawahu thiqah. He is opposing those who are thiqah. So that's the difference between the two. The munkar is weak and it's rejected and it's not taken. Okay? It's not taken. What about the shadh? It's also rejected and it's not taken. So both of them share that in the ruling. They're both the hukum. The ruling of both of them is a rad, rejection. What about the ma'ruf? Huh? The ma'ruf and the mahfuz. They're both taken. The ma'ruf and the mahfuz are both taken. They're both taken and accepted. والفرد النسبي إن وافقه غيره فهو المتابع وإن وجد متن يشبهه فهو الشاهد. Okay, the Sheikh now, rahimahullah, he is going into if there's an agreement. What did we learn? مخالفة, disagreement, right? Are you guys with me?
Yeah.
Now we're learning موافقة, agreements. If a hadith, a person singles with a narration, he's single in a narration from a particular sheikh. He's singular from a particular sheikh. Remember we took this, Fardun Nisbi is what? Fi Athna'i Sanad, right? Whilst in the chain of narration.
No.
A person turns the hadith away from the teacher alone.
Yeah.
If we find that he's got somebody else that helps him on this narration. Are you with me? Helps him. It's called mutaba'a. This is called what, eh?
Mutaba'a.
And it's two types. I'm going to go over quickly. Just listen. All of you pay attention. Don't write nothing. Just listen. And I'll give you guys an example. If the mutaba'a, because this is very tricky. The hadith, a person goes along with it. Such as, for example, Imam Malik narrates a hadith. Shafi'i is his student, Imam Malik. Yeah. Imam Malik has a lot of students. Shafi'i is not only the student. Abdullah ibn Maslamah al-Qa'anabi is from his students. You know, Muhammad ibn Idris al-Shafi'i is from his students. And others are from his students. Imam Malik, rahimahullah. Shafi'i narrates this hadith alone from Shafi'i. From Malik. Shafi'i narrates the hadith alone from Imam Malik. No one else has. This is called Fardu and Isbi. If we find that another person agrees with Shafi'i, can't be from the students of Shafi'i. In another narration, in which they both come together on the same had sahabi. They have to come together on the same companion. So another person narrates the hadith from another chain of narration, but they come together on the same hadith. So this person doesn't use Imam Malik, he uses another teacher. Okay? Na'am. But he agrees with Shafi'i on that. Are you guys with me? This hadith is called what? This hadith is called, but the companion is the same. This is called a mutaba'a. Okay. This is called a mutaba'a. If the person who's agreeing with Shafi'i is from the beginning of the chain of narration, the beginning, it's called, if it's the beginning of the chain, then it's called mutaba'a tam, complete mutaba'a. If it's in the middle of the chain, so they've singled with it as well, just like Shafi'i singled with it, then this is called mutaba'a qasira, but it's a mutaba'a. Are you guys with me?
Yeah.
If Shafi'i doesn't have anyone helping him that comes to the same companion as him, he doesn't have it. He just has a person who narrated this. There's a concept that goes according to this hadith. Overall meaning. Are you guys with me?
Yeah.
This is called the Shahid. This is called a Shahid. We're going to go now into details, inshallah ta'ala. So, mutaba'a means what? أولا اسم مصدر تابعة متابعة لغة is a مصدر تابعة بمعنى وافق if it's to agree. So the word متابعة, it means what? To agree. It means to agree. And اصطلاحا it means what? اصطلاحا means هو الحديث الذي, it is the hadith, يشارك في رواتي رواة الحديث الفردي لفظا ومعنى ومعنى فقط مع الاتحاد في الصحابي. أما in another easy term, easily simple words is أن يشارك الراوي, that narrator, others share with him, غيره في رواية الحديث, in narrating this hadith. And in this example, it becomes clear. It's two types. The mutaba'a, as I said. Mutaba'a tamma, it's a complete mutaba'a. وهو أن تحصل, it is that it happens, المشاركة للراوي من أول السند. The agreement is happening at the beginning of the chain of narration. Why is it complete if it's at the beginning of the chain of narration? If it's the beginning of the chain of narration, what does that mean? That every single person, it's not fard nisbi, is it? It's not fard nisbi now.
Yeah.
So it's good. The other chain of narration is not fard nisbi. It can be mutawatir, that's helping him.
Yeah.
It can be aziz, it can be mashhur. It's not fard, it's not singular. Because everybody's narrating it from the chain of narration.
Yeah.
But the other one is, وَهُوَ أَن تَحْصُلَ الْمُشَارَكَةِ الرَّاوِي فِي أَثْنَاءِ السَّنَدِ. It's a fard nisbi that's helping him now. Another fard nisbi. He's a fard nisbi, and another fard nisbi is helping him. Mathalan. I'm going to give you an example of a mutaba'a tamma, a muqasira, and a shahid. And a shahid. All three of them together in one an example. All of them in one example. This is ma rawahu shafi'iyu. Is that what Imam Shafi'i narrated? Fil Umm. Imam Shafi'i narrated in one book, Kitab al-Umm. He narrated from what? Malik ibn Anas, his teacher. Who narrated from who? Abdullah ibn Dinar, who narrated from Abdullah ibn Umar. So the chain of narration is like this. Shafi'i narrated from his teacher, Imam Malik. Imam Malik narrated from Abdullah ibn Dinar. Abdullah ibn Dinar narrated from who? Abdullah ibn Umar. That the messenger said, Ash-shahru tis'un wa 'ishruna, that the month is 29 nights. Fala tasumu, do not fast. Hatta tarawul hilala, do not fast until you see the crescent. وَلَا تُفْتِرُوا, and do not break your fast, meaning the month is not over, حَتَّى تَرَوْهُ, until you see the crescent again. فَإِنْ غُمَّ عَلَيْكُمْ, if it's hidden from you, meaning it becomes unclear, فَأَكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةَ ثَلَاثِينَ, and complete the month 30 days. صحيح? Are you all with me? This hadith, in this particular wording, some people thought that Shafi'i, rahimahullah, he's singular from Imam Malik. They thought that this was Shafi'i being singular from Imam Malik. So they added this to what? في غرائبه, they added this hadith to the غرائب of Imam Shafi'i. غرائب means the strange narrations of Shafi'i. Because they said that the students of Imam Malik ibn Anas, they haven't narrated the hadith with that chain of narration. And not with the, so it hasn't narrated. And with the wording, فَإِنْ غُمَّ عَلَيْكُمْ فَقْدُرُوا لَهُ. You see, they narrated it with what wording? They narrated it with the wording where it says, فَإِنْ غُمَّ عَلَيْكُمْ. Shafi'i's wording was what? If it's hidden from you, how much should you say? 30 days. They narrated it with the wording, فَإِنْ غُمَّ عَلَيْكُمْ. If it what? If it gets hidden from you, فَقْدُرُوا, estimate it for it. Estimated. فَقْدُرُوا لَهُ, estimated. They didn't say 30. Their narration, he says, estimated. This hadith is what? Has a mutaba'a tamma. Has a mutaba'a qasira. And it has a shahid. We're going to mention all of them. So with all examples, it becomes clear. First of all, the mutaba'a tamma is that which Bukhari narrated. From who? Abdullah ibn Maslamat al-Qa'nabi. Abdullah ibn Maslamat al-Qa'nabi narrated from who? Malik ibn Anas. Bil isnadi nafsi, the same exact wording, same chain of narration. So Abdullah ibn Salamah al-Qa'nabi is from the students of who? Imam Malik rahimahullah, and he narrated the same wording of Shafi'i. فَإِنْ غُمَّ عَلَيْكُمْ فَأَكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةَ ثَلَاثِينَ. That's called mutaba'a tama. By accident, said before, it can't be from the same teacher, right? Yeah, and then it can be from the same teacher. No, not a problem.